playing and having fun.
What makes a dwarf planet candidate? How does an object qualify? What makes a dwarf planet candidate? What rules do we need to apply? It must have enough mass to be round, that's one. It must have its own orbit around the sun. It can't be a moon orbiting a planet, you see. It can't have broken free from other space debris. I'm Varuna from the Kuiper Belt. Beyond Neptune, I'm so cold that my ice won't melt. I rotate fast, which changed my silhouette into an egg shape like Haumea, the dwarf planet. I'm Ixion, a trans-Neptunian object, which means I'm further from the sun than Neptune gets. Like Pluto, for every two times I orbit the sun, Neptune orbits three. I'm called a Plutino, everyone.
I'm Salacia, a trans-Neptunian object. I'm really far out way past Pluto's orbit. It's dark and cold out here, but I don't mind. My moon, Actea, is with me all the time.
What makes a dwarf planet candidate? How does an object qualify? There are so many dwarf planet candidates waiting to see if they're accepted or denied. It must have a near spherical shape, an orbit around the sun that it can't escape. Not a moon, but an independent entity that hasn't broken free from all the space debris.
Chaos! A Cubiwano is what they call me. A Kuiper Belt object not moved by Neptune's gravity. Far enough from Neptune, I have an orbit on my own. Traveling the outer solar system, exploring the unknown.
Varda, a Cubiwano, and I'm not alone. I have one moon Lamare to call my own. Both named after characters from the Silmarillion by the author of Lord of the Rings, Tolkien.
I'm Quaoar, a Cubiwano, or classical Kuiper Belt object, you know. I have icy volcanoes that spew water, not melted rock, and I have one moon with me named Waywat.
What makes a dwarf planet candidate? How does an object qualify? Makes a dwarf planet candidate. What rules do we need to apply? It must have enough mass to be round, that's one. It must have its own orbit around the sun. It can't be a moon orbiting a planet, you see. It can't have broken free from all the space debris.
Candidate Orcus and my moon Vance here, across the solar system from Pluto like a mirror. I'm called the anti-Pluto because I orbit oppositely. When Pluto's a perihelion, I'm at aphelion, you see.
2002 and us 4. Yep, discovered long ago, but I still don't have a name yet. In the Kuiper Belt, I'm waiting patiently to get an official name. What do you think it should be?
I was 2007 or 10, but was renamed. You voted, and Gǃkúnǁʼhòmdímà is who I became. In the Kuiper Belt, I have a friend with me. My little moon Shenglu keeps me company.
What makes a dwarf planet candidate? How does an object qualify? What makes a dwarf planet candidate? What rules do we need to apply? Must have a near spherical shape, an orbit around the sun that it can't escape. Not a moon, but an independent entity that hasn't broken free from all the space debris.
Sedna, I live beyond the Kuiper Belt disk. In the spherical Oort cloud is my premises. Mars and I are the reddest objects in the solar system, you see. I travel alone. I have no moon with me.
I'm the Goblin from the Oort cloud. The icy region beyond the Kuiper Belt is where I'm found. Much farther from the sun than Pluto, about 2.5 times. My discovery supports the theory that there could be Planet 9.
What makes a dwarf planet candidate? How does an object qualify? There are so many dwarf planet candidates waiting to see if they're accepted or denied.
And my dwarf planet wishes heartfelt. The fourth largest asteroid in the asteroid belt. Recent observations revealed that I'm mostly round. If promoted, I would be the smallest dwarf planet around.
Vesta, one of the fourth largest asteroids known yet. I'm differentiated much like your planet. That means I've separated into layers, crust, mantle, and core. I'm very old and hope to be promoted so I can tell you more.
2002, TX300, a member of the Haumea Trans-Neptunian Collisional Family, or Haumean. A group of objects from the same collision impact shining bright in the Kuiper Belt in an inclined elliptical orbit.
What makes a dwarf planet candidate? How does an object qualify? Makes a dwarf planet candidate? What rules do we need to apply? It must have enough mass to be round, that's one. It must have its own orbit around the sun. It can't be a moon orbiting a planet, you see. It can't have broken free from all the space debris.
Huya! A Plutino from the Kuiper Belt here in a 3-2 orbital resonance with Neptune, my dear. I have one moon that is quite large compared to me. Together we explore the outer solar system's history.
I'm 2012 VP-113, a Sednoid with a rare pinkish hue that can be seen. My perihelion is one of the farthest in our solar system, which means I'm farther out than everyone else, even when I'm closest to the sun.
2002 AW-197, that's me, a large unnamed Kuiper Belt object waiting patiently. A classical non-resonant trans-Neptunian object, also known as a Cubiwano. That's correct.
What makes a dwarf planet candidate? How does an object qualify? What makes a dwarf planet candidate? What rules do we need to apply? Must have a near spherical shape, an orbit around the sun that it can't escape. Not a moon, but an independent entity that hasn't broken free from all the space debris.
1996 TL-66, the first object categorized as being from the scattered disk. A candidate with an incredibly eccentric inclined orbit, getting very close to the sun and then really far from it.
Gǃkúnǁʼhòmdímà in the extended scattered disk, a trans-Neptunian object you don't want to miss. I have a small moon with me, go Iku. One of the reddest TNOs discovered, it's true.
What makes a dwarf planet candidate? How does an object qualify? There are so many dwarf planet candidates waiting to see if they're accepted or denied.
We are